guys, welcome to a Merryface Ground School tutorial. Tarek Merryface here. Today we'll have a look at some of the more important aspects of the traffic pattern. Entering and operating in the traffic pattern is the busiest part of the flight, therefore it's kind of important to know it inside and out. Well, this very professionally done vector drawing shows the five legs of the traffic pattern. We have the initial climb, mostly known as the departure leg, the base leg, the downwind leg, the crosswind leg, and the final approach. Note that if an aircraft joins on the other side of the pattern in the opposite direction of the downwind, it is the upwind leg. The active runway is the one that will make the final approach and landing as much into the wind as possible. The headwind will result in a lower ground speed, giving the aircraft a shorter landing distance and a lower touchdown speed. That's why I'm going to ask you to notice the windsock on the bottom right. If we look at the runway number, it looks like the wind is coming from the east. Therefore, runway 09 is active. The traffic pattern is done by making turns to the left whenever possible, as shown here. This is because the pilot in command of a fixed-wing aircraft usually sits on the left, giving him or her better visibility in the turns. However, there are times when this is not possible due to terrain, ground obstacles, restricted airspace, or other hostile sources. In this case, the traffic pattern will be done with right turns. Kind of logical, isn't it? Air traffic control will tell you left or right traffic. If it's left traffic, turn left. If it's right traffic, turn right. Can't be easier, can it? The following bullet points say it all. Whenever possible, the traffic pattern takes place at about 1,000 feet above ground level, or AGL. That means that if you were to set your altimeter to QFE, it would read 1,000 feet. We will discuss altimeter pressure settings in another lesson, so don't worry if you don't know what QFE means. Depending on the size of the airfield and of the airspeed of the aircraft being flown, the descent typically starts somewhere between halfway down the downwind leg and the beginning of the base leg. It's all about anticipation. Finally, some airfields will have different assigned traffic pattern altitude. This is usually due to conflicting airspace above the airfield. This is a segment of the visual approach chart of Lima Foxtrot Papa Zulu in the outskirts of Paris. We won't look at the chart itself in details. For now, look at the end of the downwind leg and you'll see two altitude settings. The one we're interested in right now is the one in the brackets. This is the AGL altitude of the traffic pattern, and, as you might have noticed, it's at 800 feet, not 1,000 feet. The reason behind this is that the Paris Class A airspace starts at 1,200 feet above the airfield. The 300-foot margin is there to give a safety margin between aircraft in the pattern and aircraft arriving overhead. Some airfields are in difficult terrain, discarding any possibility of having a normal traffic pattern. Irregular traffic patterns typically exist at airfields and mountainous areas. Here is the infamous Courchevel with an unforgiving final approach. As you can see, the pattern is actually triangular, allowing a slightly faster traffic flow. Airports, such as this one, make a go-around procedure impossible due to a combination of the high altitude-induced, low performance, and rising terrain on the other side of the runway. These airports usually have an abort point at the beginning of the final approach. It is due to this kind of complex procedures that specialized mountain training is strongly recommended for these operations. Well, that's it for now. Here's a quick summary of what we looked at today. If you want to revision materials for the traffic pattern, visit www.merryfaceaviation.com to download these slides and the transcript of this lesson. If you enjoyed this, hit the subscribe button and stay tuned for the next tutorial. Don't forget to check out the Facebook page, my blog, and my main channel, links for which are in the description box below. Thanks for watching, and happy flying!